So good morning. Today we're going to have stories discussion. These are our group. This is our groups. The first is this, Heliyani Putri, and then the second one is Nia Septyanti. The third, Della, Seventina, Sari, and the fourth, Atita Tamarisk. And then the last person is I, myself, Rizal Nor Wahit. So first of all, we this is our agenda today. We are going to discuss some stories, two stories of each person. It's like the stories, one story consists of 1 to 3,000 words, or even more. And it also can be a book with several chapters in it. Okay, so to make short time, let's go to the first presenter, to the first person who is going to talk.
I want to share things that I have read, and the first story is about informational text. The title is Best Ways to Stretch Your Money. Money is one of the most important material things that a person can have, because money lets us buy things we need, but money doesn't come easy. We have to work hard for it. And many people labor themselves so that they can save and have more money. The first thing that you can do to be able to cut down on your living costs. Debts are the weakness of many. This is where most of their debts. There are even people who do not feel that they get paid because they have to pay their debts. This is why it's very important that you are able to reduce, if not completely, take out the debts in your life. If you are able to save on your living costs, then you will not have a lot of things to pay for. And the second one is Heliyani.
Okay. I want to tell you about the story, the short story that I have read. Is it about the love story? The title is 100 Days at Sea. Deiki is the person who likes traveling. He had been dreaming about fast boat. It's starting during his first year at Kalaki, when he heard his teacher Paul talk about fast boat during an easy listening class. 4 years later, he was finally going to take this exciting trip around the world. When the train made a stop at Tarazuka, he met with a foreign girl got on the train. Her name is Sophia. Deki was happy to meet her. After that, they always together in their traveling, and they are falling in love with each other. Okay, next will be delivered by Nia Septyanti.
Alright, so the story that I have read titled Death on Christmas Eve. The story is about crime, more like crime stories and detective stories. And the words counted in between 2000 until 2500. Okay, so the story begins with a man walking down the street and trying to find a home of Mr. and Mrs. Celia. They both live alone in the house. Okay, so the man is actually a detective in the town. So the man, the man wants to go to their house is because the man wants to continue searching the motive or searching some issues or some cases, and wants to solve the cases that are happening in the house. Okay. In the story, it says that the wife of Mr. I forgot name is dead in 20 years ago, and the man, the detective man, wants to see the motive of why the wife is dead. And the man who live in the house with Miss Celia is actually his own sister from one mother, and the brother or the man that live in the house kept blaming Celia, his own sister, that she's the one who killed his wife. And after that, there is some kind of misunderstanding between both that the detective have found. So the man is trying not to talk to his own sister because he hates her so much, and his sister kept looking for him, kept taking care of him, even though he is blaming her. Yeah. At the end of the story, the detective still cannot find the motive of the motive of the murder, and then decide to finally leave the case alone without any partner of the from the police stations know about it, and then let the case be, because the reason why Celia killed his wife is actually happened with no reason at all and accidentally. Okay, thank you. That is my story. Next will be delivered with Atita.
Okay. My story is about the wolf and seven kids. The story is tell once upon a time, late a goat and her seven children. One day, the mother goat wants to go to shopping. She told her children to beware of the wolf and not to open the door for him. The children understood. Then, mother goat left. Not long, someone knocked the door and said, mother goat was home and she brought something to them. The children knew that voice is not their mother, and they refused to open the door. Then the wolf came back with the same voice of their mother, but it failed because they saw the wolf make paws against the window. Then the last trick, the wolf changed his paws with some white meal that he asked from a miller. He came back and knocked the door. The children opened the door, then they cried out when they knew it was the wolf. The wolf ate all of them except the youngest kid who hid in the pockets. When mother came back, she cried when her children were gone, except the youngest kid. She and the youngest kid ran out to the forest and found out the wolf left under the tree with his big tummy, because he feel that her children is still alive inside his tummy. She cut his tummy, then one by one her children came out from his tummy. Then the children fell inside his tummy with full of stones. Then she sealed up his tummy. Then after that, the wolf wake up. Then she feel thirsty. He drink into the river, but because of the stone inside his tummy, he ended up drowned miserably. When they found out the wolf has dead, they cry out and dance joyously. That's all. And the last is Rizal.
Oh. Okay. So because you guys read stories instead of I read a book, so you guys will do the telling the story twice, but I will make it only one. So this is a book that I have read the previous week and this week. This book consists of several chapters. It's The title is The Mysterious Stranger. So basically this book is about a fallen angel or a devil maybe who met who went to a village and met three boys and yeah and this. So the first of all, before the devil came to this village, it was in 1957 in Austria, in a small village. There were let's say it just three boys, and then this village also has two priests, the famous one and then the not really famous one. These three boys, okay, let's say it that one day these three boys met a stranger in a form of human. He actually, these three boys thought that this person is a stranger, so they didn't want to get close to him. But then they felt they felt pity of him, and the stranger came to him and showed him things, magics that could attract their attention. He could make fire, he could make things became leaf and many things beyond human's imagination. But then it made these three boys felt so excited about him and wondered to know more about him. After that, this boy said that his name is Satan. Actually, he said that he is not a human, he is not a thing, creature from this world. He is actually an angel, a fallen angel. After he showed things, he created a small village in a made of clay, and then he made the things became deep and very real. They acted just like humans, just like the human beings, animals and so on. But then he showed him a very terrible thing. He slapped the people, and then he made an earthquake, he made a storm, and many things happened. These tiny people were screaming in agony because of the disasters that came up upon them. And these three boys realized that this Satan actually is not a good person. Yeah, he is not actually a fallen angel, instead of him, actually he is a devil. And thus, these three boys wanted to tell to the villagers, but because the Satan taught them, Satan also showed them, Satan made them forget about the things that he has done, and only remember about the good things, that the very joyful things that they did together. And then after that, these three boys came again to Satan to see more magics and more tricks. Satan did the same thing, but with a very different way. He made it seem so friendly. So the people, the tiny people, were so happy at the time. And then he did the same thing again, but it's like these three boys felt that Satan was not a good guy again at that time for the second time. After that, Satan did a very, very joyful things to them, so they forget easily. And then these three boys said that they love Satan, they like Satan, so that they didn't want Satan to go, because Satan needed to go somewhere after this. Satan said, these three boys said, please don't go, because we like you. And then, after that, Satan showed them, okay, I will come back soon, but please don't be sad, because I will show you my magic again. At this time, Satan disappeared, but he turned into bubbles and then faded away. After that, he realized that there was someone behind the tree who was looking for the wallet. He was Father Peter, one of the priests. He was looking for the wallet which he lost. And then he found it, but the money was very, very much. He didn't own the money. It didn't belong to him at that time. And then these three boys wanted to say that this job, Satan did this because there's no people can do this except Satan. And then after that, they told Father Peter to not feel guilty because of the money. It's not his money. And then they said that just take it because no one in this village has this much money. Because it is very, very much. You can build. You can even buy a house at that time with this money. After that, the chapter 3 ends, and that's all my review for this week. Thank you. Now goes back to Della.
About my second stories which I have read. It is also about crime because I
kind of story. This story, the title is A Death Wish. The story is about there is a man named Edward Wright, and he met three things in a week. We can say in a week he met three things. The first one, he met a cop. You know, a cop is like a policeman. He met a cop on the bridge in the story, on the bridge, and he met a psychiatrist. How do you say psychiatrist? Psychiatrist, the one who care about your mental illness and so on. It's a psychiatrist. I don't know. And the third one, he met a clerk. A clerk is a British word where someone provides you a guns and a bullets. Well, this man, Mr. Wright, once met the cop on the bridge, and the cop saw him and expected that he was going to kill himself. He wants to jump over the river and finally end his life. So before Mr. Edward wanted to jump, the cop immediately came towards him and tried to talk to him about what's going on. Is there something happening? Is there something wrong happening in his life? But then Mr. Edward was actually canceled the plan. He wasn't going to suicide, to commit a suicide. He wasn't going to commit suicide. So he searched for a cigarette and finally decided to go home. And then after that, the second place that he visited was a psychiatrist place. Psychiatrist, I don't know how to pronounce it, but psychiatrist, the one that care your mental illness. He met this doctor and then tried to consult or talk about his illness, whether there's something wrong inside of his body or even in his mind. Is he crazy or something like that? Because he felt like he wanted to suicide, but he doesn't want to, because he saw the cop, and the cop tried to assure him not to commit a suicide. And the doctor feels like there's not wrong with him. So at that time, the doctor keep digging out some information from him. Then Mr. Edward was fishing by the doctor about the dream that he had, and also he were being honest to the doctor that he was taking pills that might kill him. So he told the doctor that he already took 20 pills, which 10 pills can kill him. And the doctor finally decided that this man is crazy, but the doctor is not going to tell the cops and finally arrest him because of committing suicide. And then after that, the third place that he's going to visit is the clerk, the man who's provide is not selling but provide a gun and some bullets. So he buy a gun, a very extreme gun, a very simple but extreme gun, and some bullets from the clerk, and finally get home. And then this is actually the fourth place that he visited. Mr. Edward Wright visit a house of Mr. Edwards Wright. Okay, so the first Mr. Wright that I have talked to you is actually not the real Mr. Edward. So it is the man who loved Mr. Edward's wife, because the real Mr. Edward Wright was killing his own wife because his own wife being a jackass. So his wife trying to do the right thing, but then the real Mr. Edward killed herself, and the one that pretended to be Mr. Edward, who has visited three places, it wasn't the real Mr. Edward, but it is someone that loves Mr. Edward's wife very much. And then after that, at the end of the story, the fake Mr. Edward wants to the real Mr. Edward to write some notes and try to give the cop some motive of why the real Mr. Edward's wife is dead, because the real one was killed her. The fake Mr. Edward was trying to convince the cop that Mr. Edward was the killer, was the murderer of his own wife. Okay, that is one of these. That is the story that I have read. And the next. Okay. Oh yeah, the last. Because it's the last, because Rizal has already told two stories. The last will be the perfect.
Okay. Tell you about my story. As you know, you already know this, Cinderella, but this is the original version from Grimm Brothers. As you know that after her mother's death, her father remarried again with a widower with two daughters. But they're not really good person. They treat Cinderella only like a servant. One day, the king of the kingdom invite all of women to dance party for looking a bride for his son. Then the stepmother and her daughter really excited, because if the prince become one of her daughter become his wife, they can become part of the king family. Then Cinderella want to go to the dance party, but they refuse to bring her to the dance party. But Cinderella not give up. She made a dress from her father's, but when she wore it, the stepmother and her daughter ruined the dress. They left her in the house. Then Cinderella cried out on her mother's bed. Suddenly, two pigeons bring a beautiful dress and a golden slippers to her. Then Cinderella come to the party. Her appearance really make attention to the people, including the prince. The prince falling in love with her. They dancing until the night, until midnight. Cinderella because she don't want her mother, her stepmother and stepsister find out she's not home. She hurried to get home, but she left one of her golden slippers. The next day, the prince want to search the owner of the golden slippers. When he came to Cinderella's house, the stepsisters put their feet to the slipper, but it doesn't fit. The stepmother told them to cut their heel that blood came coming up from the slippers. They married and lived ever after, happily ever after. But unfortunately, Cinderella is not forgiven first touch. At their wedding, she invites her stepmother and stepsister, then taught the pigeons that saved her life to peck out their eyes, then they become blind, then they punished to leave the kingdom. The end. That's the story that I have read.
So guys, this is the end of our discussion today for this week. Hopefully you guys enjoy it and see you again next time.